and welcome to the introduction to Photon 3.0, brought to you by CJR Gaming. My name is Christian Richards, and we'll be walking through how to get Photon 3.0 set up, how to create a server from scratch, and then how to extend that and actually get it with some functionality. I hope you really enjoy this, and so let's get started. As you can see here, I have a website up. It is at the Exit Games Download Photon. I've signed in with my account, and so what you'll want to do is you need to download the Exit Games Photon's version 3, the latest version that they have. Currently the latest version is RC3. You'll also want to grab the Photon 3 free license, 100 concurrent users with no expiration. And then lastly, you'll want to grab the Photon Unity 3D SDK RC1 or whatever the latest version is at the when you are watching this video. I have already gone to the liberty of downloading those. You can see them here. I've got the SDK, the Unity SDK, and my free license. First thing you're going to want to do is you're going to want to go ahead and extract that server SDK. I place mine on almost on the root of the directory under a folder called Photon. Feel free to put it wherever you like, and just remember where you put it. I already extracted mine out. As you can see here, it has four different folders in it: a deploy, documents, library, and then the source for the server. So if we go into the deploy folder, you will see that we have a tools folder in which is the Bear Trail logging program that Exit Games uses. We have the 7-Zip program, their dashboard program, their performance monitoring program, and then another program called Stardust. After that, we've got four binary files, which are folders, which refer to the different versions of Windows that you might have, whether it's 32-bit, 64-bit, and then more specifically if you're running a 32 or 64-bit version of XP. I run Windows 7, so I mainly worry about the Win64. If we open up that, you can see several command files which do things such as starting and stopping Photon as an application, setting up Photon as a service. We have our license file, which at this time, if you are in the folder for your computer, you will want to go ahead and drag that license file on in here and go ahead and delete that temporary license. If for some reason you think you need to have that file, you can always come back to the Photon website, and that is right here, their trial license 30-day limit. So you can always get back to that. Next we have just the DLLs that they use, and then they have Photon Control. This file is a taskbar application which allows you to control what Photon is doing at the time. So it lets you start up your instance, restart your instance, stop it. It allows you to bring up the logs specific to how you're running, and also allows you to launch the performance monitoring. The next important file we have that we won't open up right now but we will look at later is the config file. Inside that file, it will show you what applications your server is going to run when you start up one of the instances. And lastly, we have the socket server exe. This file is what is run when you launch Photon as an application. It allows you to bring up Visual Studio, connect to that executable, and then be able to debug what your program is doing. So it can be very helpful if you're running into issues and your logs aren't giving you good enough feedback and you really need a step up from what you're normally working with. Next we have all of these applications. We have the counter publisher, which is Exit Games' way of keeping track of specific statistics. When you write your program, you can add counter code to it, which will show up in the publisher. It can show you things like the number of games you have running, how many users are on your system. It's really just a generic framework that allows you to keep track of what's going on with your machine while it's running. Next, we have three different folders. We have the Light, Light Lobby, and Light Web Sockets. The Light Lobby is an addition to the Light Game. The Light Lobby allows you to have an application that runs as a lobby, and you can see what rooms are available and what games are going on, which is what is controlled in the Light application. The Light application sets up rooms, sets up games. It's got a simple little grid game just to showcase what Photon is capable of. Next, we have the load balancing folder. Inside the load balancing folder, when we get to the source, you'll see that they have a master server and they have two game servers that are attached to that. You as a client would connect to the master server, find out what games are running. If you wanted to create a game, the load balancing kicks in and it allows you to do things like request a new game to be created. It will look at the servers in the game servers in the background and go which one has less latency, which one has fewer games, and that can even be customized to give you a really robust load balancing. And then it says, okay, go create a game there. It passes you back the information on what server it's on, and then you as the client would disconnect from the master server, reconnect to the game server, and it would log you into the game. Next we have the MMO demo, which is Exit Games' showcase of their demo of their MMO code. You can configure it so that it has the Unity Island, and when you connect as an avatar, you'll see other AIs that you can create running around on the island. It showcases their concept of items. It showcases their concept of an interest manager, which is a way of keeping track of items around you without needing to know about all the items all over the world. So you really can narrow it down to only knowing about stuff within a certain radius of your avatar. Next we have the policy application. And that's necessary for things like Silverlight. For the web player, they have to talk to a policy server to know whether they're dealing with a really secure server or not, and whether or not to allow certain functionality when you're dealing with the web. Lastly, there is the unit test networking, which is just their unit test to make sure that their stuff is working. And then I skipped over the log folder. Inside the log folder, it keeps track of all the logging that your applications are doing while it's running on the server. So if you run into an error, you can tell the log, hey, I want you to output the error stack trace, and the stack trace will show up there. You can put in debug messages to say, hey, I made it this far, and help you along with debugging if you don't want to connect directly through Visual Studio, or if, for instance, you are running on a server that's in a server farm and you don't have a way of connecting with Visual Studio. That way you get the logs and you can find out what's going on and can help debug what happened with your server if something happens. So that's it for the deploy folder. Next we have the doc folder, inside which you'll find stuff such as the README, a PDF covering the performance counter, the licensing information, what Photon's configuration is like, and then a help file covering the socket server API, which details, you know, what function calls you can make, what the purpose of those function calls are, just like you would expect with either Java docs or with the MSDN library documentation. Next we have the lib folder, inside which you will find Zgraph, which is something that the performance monitor uses, as well as the counter program. It gives you graphs of what's going on in the system at a specific time. We have Exit Games logging, which they've already built in a bunch of the logging stuff. It makes it very easy and very simple for us to go in, set up a logger, and be able to write logs out. Next we have the Exit Games libs, which is just the common library functionality that you need to access. We have log4net, which is Apache's logging, which is what ties in with the Exit Games logging to give you real logging. They have InUnit, which is for their unit tests. Photon Socket Server, this is what we'll be working with mostly with the server. You won't want to pull this onto the client. This is specifically for the server to have all the classes and everything you need to work on the server. Then we have the .NET specific functionality. The socket server can be somewhat generic, and so the .NET stuff is really going in and telling .NET what it's supposed to be doing. Then there's the host runtime interfaces, which is all the other interfaces that are used within Photon, and we'll take a look at what of those we use. As you can see, the library is not very big, so there's not a whole lot there that we are concerned with. Then they have the Photon Unity 3D DLL, as well as the Unity Editor and Unity Engine. I'm not real sure why they included those in the folder. They did, so they're there and easy to access. I believe it's actually there for their client code that is in the source server folder, which is what we'll be looking at next. Inside the source server, you actually have all the source for each of those applications that I talked about. You have the source for the counter publisher. You have the source for the light lobby and the light application. You have the source for the load balancing. And with our introduction, once we get past the actual introduction, the load balancing is where we're going to be borrowing a lot of code from. There are certain functionality that Exit Games has already created in their load balancing that easily pulls into creating a multi-server farm, which we'll touch on in the coming videos. You have the code for their MMO demo, so you've got all the code there. It includes the code for how to get the Unity Island to work, how to get the Windows grid, which is just literally a grid with avatars that move around on the grid, the Unity version of that grid, and then there's the Unity specific code and the .NET specific code. And then we have the common code between both client and server, as well as the server code. So it's all there for you to take a look at, open up, be able to read. We aren't going to worry about this as much because it can be very confusing to jump into an application that already works and try and understand. That's why we're going to go in and we're going to create a server from scratch. And again, then the last thing is the policy application. That last policy thing, again, is for Silverlight, Flash, Unity 3D Web Player. All of those things have to be able to talk to a policy server to know whether or not they're accessing the information correctly, how to go about getting the secure connection, and you know, anything that deals with those type of web-based security features. And so that's it. That's all of Photon. Next, we're going to go ahead and run Photon to make sure that it's up and running correctly. So if you go into whichever bin folder you work out of, 64-bit Windows 7 would be using Win64, 64-bit XP is of course the 64-bit XP, so on and so forth. Just come on in, click on the Photon control. You have to give it permissions to be able to run. And so it'll take a couple of seconds and it'll show up down here in the toolbar after it's already up and running. So we'll just give that just a little bit of time to start up, and then we'll take a look at the features in there. So there it is. Now you can see it. You hover over it, it says Photon stopped. If you right click, you can see you've got the Photon control, what version of it is, enabling auto start to where if it starts up automatically when your system boots up, that's helpful for servers so that if your system reboots, it'll automatically start back up, your servers will start back up, and you won't have to worry. License information, as you can see, I put my license file in here so you can see that it's registered to me. It's got a 100 connection that never expires, and then it's locked down to this specific hardware, which is my machine there. Next, we have the Photon Instance 1, which you can start as an application or you can install as a service. Instance 1, when we later on go in and look at the Photon server config, Instance 1 is all of the applications with the exception of the load balancing. So it's got Light, Light Lobby, the performance monitor, the counter program, the policy, all of those things are run in Instance 1. The Instance load balancing, like it says, is the load balancing application itself. It is specifically built just for handling multiple applications running within the same application space. So for instance, we'll have a server with the two game servers for this load balancing. You will have those running there, and all three of them start up in a specific order, and then once all three of those are started up, those are the only things that run in that instance. Next, we have the dashboard, which you can install as a service, and then after Photon is running, you can open it up, and that's how you can see what's going on with the servers, how much memory is being used, that type of thing. And then next is the performance counters, where you can take a look at what statistics your server is outputting, how many users, how many games, how many rooms, etc. We have the open logs, which runs their bear trail, and this is helpful to have up and running just so you can see, oh, you know, a certain application crashed, here's why. And if you don't handle certain exceptions, this log is where those exceptions will show up. So the next thing that we can go ahead and do just to make sure that this is working is you can go ahead and install as a service instance 1, and you'll get this little dialog once it's actually installed. Once it's installed, go ahead and start the service, and you will see the logs start to populate as the service begins to come up and writes to the logs saying what services are running, what instances are running, so on. So here in a second we should see some log information put up. You can see here that in the CLR log, it's creating the domain manager, it's talking to the license server that Exit Games runs to make sure that your license really is valid. And then it begins to create the different applications. This log is the older log, so actually if I go ahead and close this and I open up the logs again, you will see today's log, which shows all of the applications starting up. Light Lobby has started, Light has started, the MMO demo has started up, and so you can see all those things running as they're going along. And so that's it. Once you have seen this log file and you see the applications loading and they aren't crashing immediately, that means Photon is set up correctly. So we're going to go ahead and wrap up this video. In the next one, we're going to bring up Visual Studio and we're going to start creating our server from scratch and figure out how to get that running from within our Photon instance. Thanks, and see you then.